here sequence of real numbers. Real numbers is a function. Is a function from I into R. Here I is a set of positive integers and R is a set of real numbers. That is, the sequence is a mapping from I into R. Sequence is a function which is mapping from I into R. That is, I is a set of positive integer and R is a set of real numbers. This is a sequence of real numbers. Next one, limit of a sequence. Limit of a sequence. Let SN be a sequence of real numbers. SN be a sequence of real numbers. We say that SN approach the limit L means if it satisfies the one condition, that is, given epsilon greater than 0, there exists a positive integer n belongs to I such that modulus of SN minus L is less than epsilon for all n is greater than or equal to n. Limit of a sequence that SN approach the limit L means if it should satisfy the condition, that is, given epsilon greater than 0, there exists a positive integer n belongs to I such that modulus of SN minus L is less than epsilon. This is your limit of a sequence. Next one is convergent sequence. Next one is convergent sequence. What is meant by convergent? When the sequence approaches the limit L means that sequence is said to be convergent. That is, let sequence of SN be a sequence of real numbers which has a limit L means we say that this sequence SN approach the limit L. That is, limit n tends to infinity SN equal to L. That is convergent sequence. Let SN be a sequence of real numbers which has a limit L means we say that the sequence is a convergent. That is, limit n tends to infinity less than equal to L. Next one, divergent sequence. Divergent sequence. Let SN be a sequence of real numbers. Let sequence SN be a sequence of real numbers. We say that this sequence of SN, we say that this sequence of SN does not have a limit. Means this sequence is called convergent sequence, that let SN be a sequence of real numbers. The sequence have a limit L means we say that the sequence is a convergent sequence. Divergent means does not have a limit. Next, we will discuss some another sequences, that is non increasing and non decreasing sequences. Non increasing and non decreasing sequences. First of all, what is mean by non decreasing sequence? Non decreasing means increasing sequence. Let sequence of SN be a sequence of real numbers if it satisfies the condition that S1 less than or equal to S2 less than or equal to S3 less than or equal to etc. Sn less than or equal to Sn plus 1, etc. When the sequence satisfies this condition, we say that the sequence is a non-decreasing sequence, that is increasing sequence. Similarly, non-increasing sequence, non-increasing sequence means that SNP is equal to real numbers, that sequence satisfies the condition, that is S1 greater than or equal to S2 greater than or equal to S3 etc. Sn greater than or equal to Sn plus 1 etc. This is a non-increasing sequence. Next one, monoton sequence. Monoton sequence means that sequence of SN be a sequence of real numbers which is both, there is not increasing or not decreasing, means which is called monoton sequence. Next topic is operations on convergent sequence. Operations on convergent sequence. Operations on convergent sequence. In that topic, we have to discuss about one familiar theorem. That is, we have to use some operations, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. First one, theorem. One statement of this theorem is the limit of the two convergent sequence is equal to the limit of the two convergent sequence is equal to the limit of sum of the two convergent sequence is equal to the sum of the limits. The limit of the sum of the two convergent sequence is equal to the sum of the limits. Statement proof. What is the given condition? The limit of sum of two convergent sequences is the given condition. We have to prove that value is equal to the sum of the limits. So let us consider two convergent sequences, that is given or assumption, given sequence of SN and sequence of TN are the two convergent sequences, which is the given condition. Convergence means, what is the definition of convergence sequence? Limit n tends to infinity Sn equal to L, and limit n tends to infinity Tn equal to M. To prove limit n tends to infinity Sn plus Tn, limit of the sum of the convergence sequence is equal to sum of the limits, that is L plus M, that is equal to L plus M. Okay, since limit n tends to infinity Sn equal to L means it should satisfy the definition of convergent. So, what is the definition of convergent sequence? That is given epsilon greater than 0, there exists a positive integer n1 belongs to I such that modulus of Sn minus L is less than epsilon by 2. Therefore, on n is greater than or equal to n. Next given condition is limit n tends to infinity Tn equal to M. So, we have to apply the same definition for the second sequence, that is given epsilon greater than 0, there exists a positive integer n2 belongs to I such that modulus of Tn minus M is less than epsilon by 2 for all n is greater than or equal to n. Here we have to choose two integers, that is n1 and n2, but we need only one integer, that is n. So let us consider, let n equal to maximum of n1 comma n2. So applying this condition we get Yeah. is less than or equal to modulus of Sn minus L plus modulus of Dn minus M. What's the value for this one? That is less than epsilon by 2. This is also epsilon by 2. Epsilon by 2, epsilon by 2 is equal to epsilon for all n is greater than or equal to n. That is modulus of Sn plus Dn minus